I'm back. Kinda. I'm back to yelling at the void. I doubt anyone's actually gonna join this, but if someone's here, hello, hello. Figured I'd give streaming a shot again. Might make it like a once a week thing. But, you know, why don't we just start off again with a little bit of Magic the Gathering and chill. Figured it would be good. And raise up the volume a little. There we go. I think that's comfortable. I actually have no idea how loud everything is. I should probably check that, huh? One moment. Fine. I think we should be good there. Yeah. Just figured we'd do some chill Magic the Gathering. Also gonna play Brawl. I could play a little bit of Explorer, but not really feeling it today, so I think I'm just gonna try a little bit of Brawl. Going to use my Exile deck. Exile deck. It's a Roko deck. It's literally just meant to generate a bunch of food and go ham off of that. And I already do not like this hand. I'm gonna switch it up. This is much better. I can work with this. Start off by playing the Stonebinder Familiar. I wanna change this. I'm not picking up my cursor. There we go. Perfect. Move myself a little bit up here. Now, we'll keep it here. Right there. Right there is fine. The Lina deck, so it's probably aggro-ish, I want to say. Yeah, let's go for Arcane Signet. Pass from there. Hazard. Could Swords the Ragavan, but I'm not sure if I want to save it. No, I'll Swords the Ragavan. Don't necessarily want them getting ahead of me. Shock in the Sacred Foundry and play Roko. Start getting the generation. Game of Summer, that's not really going to be useful here. Hazard Monument, that's fine. Fox Amber, let's do Nor. Ooh, Planar Disruption. Okay, that could be good. Music a little bit. Heraldic Banner. Ash Guard. Axe Guard Cavalry. Okay. Might as well put the Planar Disruption on it. In this deck, it's very much use it or lose it. So I'm gonna do that. And that'll hopefully shut down some of its... their... ability to really work properly. Sack of food so I can get a fetch a land from Eleanor. So... grab a Plains. Ren's Resolve. Perfect. Perfect, perfect card for me to grab off that. Oh, no, Eleanor. I want to spread it a little. Get to speed. Yeah, they're gonna boot to speed Delina so they can start getting copies right away. Okay, let's get to one. Good. Take a bit of damage, that's fine. Let's play a Ren's Resolve. Street. Ooh, Mirari's Wake. Okay. Never trust the auto tapper. Kill the self savior. Boom. Not gonna be able to keep up mana for surge, but this will definitely be useful in the long run. Keep Eleanor open just in case they swing with Delina again. And if for whatever reason they decide to kill Eleanor, I can Sylph the Savior. And the crafting, whenever an ability of a shaman or another trigger. Okay. So this is gonna trigger twice. This is fine. I think this is fine. Ooh, Ember Cleave. Okay. Wait, is that lethal? Oh, that is lethal. Oh, dang. Ouch, that sucks. Alright, well, first game is a loss, but that's fine. Yourself up. No need to... no need to get down about it. I think I had the right idea earlier. I think I'm gonna move myself down just a little here. There we go. Aragorn deck, eh? Okay. Most likely they're gonna be playing wide and playing big. It's gonna be a bit of an issue. This hand has some good stuff in it, it's just a little slow. A lot of Aragorn decks tend to be a bit slow, so I think I can afford it. but at the same time, I'm not quite sure. No, I'm not Morgan. Let's see what I get. Okay, this is not much better, but it's... Oh. Immediate once upon a time. Okay. Lionel Elves. Play the den. Play the box. Is it worth? No, I think it's worth Heliod punishing the Aragorn when it comes out, so I'm gonna pass. I don't like the way that this is going. Also, god dang it, it's an elf, and these things are like paragraph long. Got 20 or more creatures in your put one on until everything. Gosh. I'm not a super big fan of alchemy. In fact, I'm gonna be frank, I don't really like alchemy at all. I try to build my decks without any alchemy card. This deck has one, and it's mainly just used for removal. I forgot the name of it. It's like humiliation something. But yeah, not a super big fan of the not a big fan of, let's say, alchemy, just because I think a lot of the effects almost feel cheaty in a way. I don't know. I'm gonna take a lot of damage. This sucks. I think I've already lost. I don't think there's really any way I can recover from this. So what, I can play Rocco, Shocken, Temple Garden, put in Heliod's Punishment on the Aragorn. That's not gonna cut it. Alright, well, I had the right idea in terms of playing fast, so I'm glad I didn't take the other hand. It's just unfortunate that the hand that I also got from the mulligan is not that good. Wasn't that good. It's not that good. Against the chase deck, which means it's against a mill. She probably will again. It's not really gonna be the best. Veil of Summer is there, and I feel like that's gonna bail me out, but the fact that there's Lightning Bolt and Ragavan when I don't have a red is kinda crummy. I do go first, so I can't try to hope to draw into it. I might just have to take another mulligan. Oh, this is even worse. Guess we'll keep this. We'll put the Elish Norn back because we're not going to be able to play it anytime soon. Play Spikefield tap. Okay. Play Jetmir tap. I'm going to try to Inspiring. Most likely they have a counter. No, no counter. Alright. We'll take those. But they do just release them. Oh, I'm a doofus. I should have tireless provision first. Also, Alice Peter, thank you for the follow. I am doing well. How are you? Want a Llanowar? Not too sure. Let's try Inspiring first. How's the stream going? In all honesty, I'm just kind of like spouting into the void. I figured like, hey, I used to stream a little bit earlier in the year, but I stopped for reasons. But I figured, hey, I'm gonna be here playing games over the course of the summer. I might as well stream them. Put something out in the world. Otherwise, it's chill. As for Sentinel. I'm gonna go for a showdown. Rocco. I think the best course of action is to just show down. I wish that tapped a little better so I can play the S per Sentinel. Magic's fun. It's a card game, as you can see. Playing a very casual version of the game, so it's not too high stakes or anything. It can get a little complicated, but I find complex games to be kind of fun, so... I'm not sure how easy that makes it to, like, viewers who haven't necessarily seen the game. But the general concept is just to get your opponent to zero life. And you do that by casting spells and doing a bunch of, like, playing creatures and attacking with them and stuff like that. Swing in the Llanowar for one damage. Bounce back my Rocco. Cool that you do artwork for streamers. I will just be a little bit blunt. I'm not necessarily interested in gonna be particular, but mostly just because I tend to do a lot of my own stuff. Like the PNG tuber that I have here is one that I made. But thank you. If that was like the direction you're going. I'm also not necessarily privy to sharing Discord. I tend to be a bit of a private person in terms of like that sort of direct communication, but yeah. Sorry about that. Oh, what did you? Oh, gain control of target permanent. Ugh. Let's play Lauren. Just get rid of my Esper. So that's gonna suck and I'm gonna have to kill it. I thought this would be nil. It looks more like control. Shit. I'm not seeing too many nil options here. Let's play Lauren. Or put it on Lauren. Tapped out of mana, and I don't necessarily think they can do anything with one mana. And I can start just chaining stuff with Kami and Rosie. Okay, I think that's game. Play the Kami. Put it on Lauren. They try to counter it. That sucks. Treasure. Play Rosie. Be lethal. Swing with everything. They try to bounce anything, or can they just surge? And they opt. That's game. Go again. Better. That is better, I suppose. To Elvish. I can do Overgrown. Let's do Raka since they're tapped out. Go into another Land of War. Let's hope they don't have a board clear of some kind, because that would be spooky. Another couple actions. Trail of Crumbs. Let's jam. Swing, swing, swing. Exile, exile, exile. Oh, you know, I could have played that. I could. Never mind. Put it on Rocco. You know, we shouldn't actually be leaning on Rocco so much. Childred, okay. Do they kill Rocco? They don't, they just bounce it in hand. Okay. That is fine. Let's try to find another mountain because I'll be able to play Lila. Unfortunately, that is a non-artifact. I'm gonna play this Fable then. Let's put it on Rocco. If I happen to have a board wipe of any kind, this is gonna end in a tragedy. Comes with Honor. Sad. Protection from everything, that's no bueno. Decline from that. Let's play Guardian Project. I'm gonna play Rocco. You know, maybe playing Guardian Project wasn't a good idea. At least not until I got rid of the Shieldred. Because, dang. There's the board clear I was thinking of. Let's definitely move Rocco back to the command zone. This is gonna be rough. I really need to get that Shieldred off the field. If I don't, it is going to be a massive pain in my behind. Oh wait, did they get rid of... Oh, they did get rid of Curse of Hospitality. I didn't notice that. Did they do that? One, two, three, four, five, and then the rest of the colors. A card, I'm gonna take some damage. Let's play the Fire Weaver. Okay, let's play the Dragon Spark. Swing in the Lyra. Wait, do they have Chetmir in there? Oh no, it's my library. Though. Don't like that at all. That's a lot of card draw. That is quite a lot of card draw. Oh no, there goes Rocco again. Put him back in the command zone. I don't remember what these things are. Oh, it's the one that gives extra damage on instants and sorceries. Children. Interesting. Figured they would have actually swung in with children. Oh, wait. No, that's just death. Like field. Oh, reflection. Okay. That's game. Rip. Ripperoni. Not doing too well here. I'll do a couple more games. At least with this deck, and then we might switch to. I'll switch over to Explorer. Ragavan turn one sounds pretty decent, and then I also have Trail of Crumbs right after. Ragavan. And I guess they're just gonna concede from that. Alright. I'm gonna take it that they didn't have a an answer for that. Funny monkey. This is a pretty decent hand. Is there anything about this that I would want to necessarily change? What are they playing? Chandra the Awake Inferno, which might mean they're just playing Burn. So that could be bad. I'm not entirely sure. Lanowar Elves for now. Okay, goodbye Lanowar Elves. Let's play the Den. Okay. Chetmere's Garden into Goldhound. Gonna need a. Well, I have a white source of Jetmere. I just kind of wish I had it a little earlier because I wanted to play this familiar. Okay. Trials with a Brink. Bankbuster. Lightning Bolt. I don't think it's necessarily worth it. Save it for Rocco, because most likely he's going to be the one that's going to need it. Let's play Rocco. Cathartic Pyre, okay. Then I got Swords of Plowshare, which isn't going to be useful here. Don't think they're going to play a creature. Chandra, address the kill. Might as well keep up mana. Mana efficiency. Let's kill Chandra. Trust the kill. And then Spiring Statuary. Tireless Provisioner, but no land to play it with. That's a shame. What do you have? And Buster goes down to its last mark and he gets the pilot and the treasure. Okay, nothing happens there. Got a land, that's good. Put it on Rocco. Holding up mana. Or at least holding priority. It might just be because they can technically pilot the Bank Buster, but I don't. They can't actually use it to block or anything, so it's just holding up their priority. But who knows? They might actually have like a burn spell in hand or something. This forest. Let's get the treasure. Play the Elvish. Swing in with Rocco. Blocks Rocco. Okay. Still have priority. So they could do something. And they don't. Cool. Burn down the house. Not cool. Let's turn Rocco indestructible. Still holding up priority. Priority. Okay. Ooh, Ragavan. Okay. It's Sukansen. Rocco. Play Ragavan. We're gonna dash him in. Because we need to get that hit in. Rocco. Play the stone bind. And there. frostbites the stonebind. That's fair. Does mean that I am completely empty-handed now. Lila's gonna help with that. Alright. Well, that's game. Alright. Let's give it one more go, and then I'm gonna play a couple, let's do a couple, Explorer games. Can Xanathar. Could possibly be a... Could possibly be a control deck. It's not necessarily a good hand against that. This is decent. Ideally, I want to get Rocker out as soon as I can. Thoughtseize. Ouch. If they take out the Arcane Signet, that's going to be a huge blow to me. But... Oh, they get rid of the Fable. Interesting. But Stonebind. Cold Steel Heart. And blue. Let's play the Arcane Signet. Guardian Isle. Okay. They're just continuing to ramp. They got one blue. Silent Start. Okay. That's kind of like a counter. Not really, though. Let's do Sacred. Let's play Rocka. Swing in with the familiar. They decide to block it with the tamer. I think that's a worthy trade. Kill spell in hand, in which case I'm a little scared. Because they could kill Rocka, and I don't really have a good way to recover after that. Tablet Soul Broker. Okay, this guy has a ton of stuff. I have no idea what he actually does, though. That minus three is a little scary. Offers and conditions. What the heck even are the offers and conditions? I don't even think there's a way I can see it. Ugh, alright. What's this? Spells cost casts. One black less to cast. Did you have a friend? Counter duplicate of the top card and prevent you against me spend that within the access to the top card. Okay. I don't actually. This is my alchemy problem again. I have no idea what any of these cards do. They're very strange. Do I play Lila? Could play Paragon Took. No, let's play Lila. Swing. We'll swing to here at Daffriel, and we'll swing Lilia at face. So if they want to keep Daffriel alive, they have to block with both of the creatures, which I think I'm fine with. And then I don't necessarily see them blocking Lilia specifically. Yeah, okay, they're just gonna let everything go ahead. Really, I need better. That's fine. A-okay with me. Probably gonna board wipe right now. Yep. Alright. Back in hand. They're relying really heavily on those rocks. So we're gonna blow one of them up. By Shark Typhoon. Let's get rid of the cold steel. Just play blue. There's Xanathar. That's really scary, actually. Let's see what I can get here. Alright, let's see what I can get here. I guess it's not the worst. Probably would have fought it better.
And they might be able to just turbo
off of my top
library. Top my library.
Position of Kozilek. They can hit any of those. What is this again? Queen Marchesa, Resident Mark. And attacks, remove all counters from the target and hit it at the beginning of the game. We have it done. Okay. The question is, do they swing into me or do they swing into Fiora? Or do they not swing in at all? I think the smart choice is actually just not swing. Fiora is also not a bad choice. And it's just gonna be a big body that I am going to have some trouble dealing with. Okay, what can we do? We can play Esper. Sorry, we can do Kami. Oh, that's rough. I would have loved that to be the next card I had. Very confused. We'll do Kami first. Play the Esper Sentinel. Place it on the Kami. And play Gold Horror Hound. Place it on the Esper. Let's. If I do that, I can't really do anything else. Alright, we'll play Lawrence Escape and put it on the Kami. Put it on the Gold Hound, I guess? See if I can utilize that first strike. Make sure that that's not at the top because I don't want him grabbing that. I have a clue to use if I really need it. Huh? Oh, that's rough. That's really rough. That sucks a lot. I guess they can just remove the counters, like the actual plus one counters. I'm gonna let that slide, let that hit me. I think... unless they pull a really big board out of nowhere, just go all in and win from there. Tell me a secret. The archive. Demonic tutor. Interesting. What can you grab that is one mana that can potentially save you? Just game though. No? Put everything on the gold helm. Here we go. Well, yeah, that's fine. Gold Hound, they have nothing, and that is game. Alright. Alright, let's do one round of explore. This could be a mirror match. I reckon this is a Kuruga enigmatic deck. So it's going to be mainly focusing on getting enchantments out and then cheating out big stuff. Although, now that I'm looking at this hand again, I probably shouldn't have taken it. Doesn't really have much that helps me advance here. Especially not against the mirror match. There. don't necessarily want to play the Enigmatic right away, just because I don't have anything to use it on, and if I leave it open, then it gives the possibility that they just, like, take it. So we're just gonna put Karuga in our hand and see what they have. They're playing a lot of light. So this is, yeah, okay, there's the Enigmatic. This is the thing that I was actually worried about. Funny. Is that shoulder? So if they start drawing cards, I can start damaging them. Mention the Spirit Realm. I don't think they get rid of touch, right? Or do they? They do. Interesting. Do they bring out... They could do Shieldred, they could do, okay, they could Shieldred of their own. Fair. Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. Shoot. It's fine. You know what? It probably actually would have been best if I swung in. Let's play this Fable. This island. We're gonna Enigmatic. Get the 2 mana for Bone Crusher. Most likely just stomp their face. If I don't have any particular targets. I don't think I'm actually am gonna hit any good targets with Bone Crusher, so when I go back for second round, I should probably take out Bone Crusher. Another touched Spirit Realm. Okay. I swing in the Shieldred. Okay. Do they get rid of touch again? Nope. Okay, they're gonna keep that one. Bone Crusher. Here is where we go off. We play Enigmatic. I'm gonna go to end step. We're gonna sacrifice both Enigmatic to each other. I'm gonna grab Elesh Norn. And we're gonna grab Talismir. I'm gonna use the wolves that he spawns to kill Shieldred. Oh, they just concede after that. Interesting. Okay. Alright. Temporary lockdown is completely useless here. There's no reason to have it. I'm gonna take out 2 of the Boneless Crushers. It's playing. Distortion, we'll put in the Brazen Borrower. Do I want to play Mystic Dispute? That is a question. That is a question. I could take out 2 of the Fable. No, I don't think I want to play Mystic, so... Going to just roll with this. Yeah, that's a pretty good hand. Pretty decent. Play a Spawn. Next turn we can play a Ziyorda Proving Ground and have enough for the main line, should we need it. Wait, where's those Karuga? Did they? happened to the Karuga? Did they put it in the deck? Where did the Karuga go? Okay. Depending on what they play, I can just go straight into Enigmatic. We'll grab Itali and just try to get two good things. Or, barring that, I'll just play this mountain and play on that. Just in case of a counter. Or like a bounce or something. Mainline bindings the Omnath. Okay. Still have to draw a card. Very neato. Fires of Invention is tempting. I don't think I want to play it right now. That's a bit suspicious. Let's go ahead and grab a blue from this island. I'm gonna touch the spirit realm, the reflection of the PPGP. Might want to Brazen Borrower the this Leyline Binding so I can get my Omnath back. Alpha Shaman. Let's make it two. Get to treasure. What do you have? What do you have, silly boy? I want my Omnath back. If you don't mind. This thing disputes it. Interesting. Okay. I think this is time for Enigmatic now. Play the Triumph. We go to Ensign. Oh, they're gonna ley lined again. Okay. That sucks. Fires into shield. Not the worst idea. That's a mirror. Interesting. Well, hello there, Brazen Borrower. Let's play a Shielder first. Okay, they don't have anything in response. Oh, but if I do, that's a thought. If I Leylined, or if I bounce back the Leyline, they just play the Leyline again. Can't really do that. Alright, well, that shield root is just gonna be a problem then. And I could stomp on either the reflection or the goblin shaman. You can't do that, friend. I'm gonna stomp on your goblin shaman. So now you just have a sad, tapped Reflections of Kiki Cheeky. Oi, yay, yay. That's no good. That is no good.
I hope. What do they give? Do they give me the Omnath one? They do.
Okay. I have a question. What do you have? I swear if it's the Agent of Treachery, I'm going... Please don't be Agent of Treachery. Cool, Sign of Industry. Cool. Cool. Red target artifact, you're just gonna break my ley line for no reason? Okay. Okay. We'll draw a bunch with Karuga, and I don't think that's actually the worst option here. So what we're gonna do... Fires of Invention. Pay the 3 for Karuga. And then we're gonna play Karuga because of Fires of Invention. Draw 3 cards. Gain 6 life. And... yeah. Cool. Play another Titan of Industry. Which probably means we're just gonna destroy the... fires again, and then maybe make another 4/4? But I don't know. Put a shield counter on something? Yeah, okay. Should we put it on the Titan? Put it on the... what? Huh? I think they might have... huh? I didn't sync with that right. Also, let me do like that. There we go. I'm so confused. What? What the heck? Okay, there goes the Titan. Do they break another... they lied? These two are significantly more dangerous to break. Because if they do the Touch of the Spirit Realm, because of the way sequencing works, they'll get their creature first, and then I get the trigger. And they're gonna do the enigmatic. Okay. There's a Traxa. Oh, they also have a Thought Distortion. Why do you have Temporary? Why do you still have Temporary in your deck, my man? Temporary doesn't do anything. The only thing it hits in my deck is the Goblin Shaman that gets made from Fable, and I guess any of the treasure tokens. There's no reason to have that. I literally can't put anything under 3 mana in my deck, so it doesn't work. Ooh, now that is an interesting proposition. I guess I'm gonna have to just bounce the Atraxa back. Yeah, this doesn't sound like the worst idea. Alright. Play the Fable Passage. I don't have any mana to spend on the... oh, you know what? Yes, I did. I did actually have mana to spend. Crap. That's an interesting idea.
Well, let's cycle, at least. I know that that's technically gonna put me at bigger risk. But that's... it ended up fine. Okay. I could do another Fires, but at this point I have a lot of mana. I don't necessarily need a Fires Invention. But, use him or lose him. He's gonna most... I don't know if they're gonna Thought Distortion next. It's a huge possibility that they could. The blue spike, maybe. Okay. Here's the funny thing we do. We break the Fires Invention, and we grab Elish Norn. That Enigmatic does nothing, your Atraxa does nothing, any of the battlefield, enter the battlefield stuff does nothing. If they can't even do Leyline Binding, because that also does nothing. I shut down a good chunk of the deck with just Elish Norn. Yeah, that's game.
Hooray!
Wonderful. Alright, and I think that's gonna do it for my stream for now. Alice Peter, if you're still here, thank you for following and for watching. Thanks a lot. Anyone else that happens to be here, thank you. And I will be back sometime soon. I don't know when, but I'll try to make an effort to stream a little bit more. With that, I will be gone. Bye-bye.